When we think of threats from outer space, images of deadly solar flares, planet-destroying asteroids, or hostile alien takeovers may come to mind. However, the most dangerous threat to Earth might be something microscopically small. NASA is deeply concerned about the presence of space microbes and the potential damage they could cause if they were to reach our planet. Furthermore, if we are not careful, we may inadvertently introduce life to other planets, raising questions about how we could wipe out life elsewhere. In this article, we will explore the significance of space microbes, the risks they pose, and the importance of strict contamination protocols. Within the observable universe, which consists of approximately 100 to 200 billion galaxies, the existence of life on other planets remains undiscovered. However, given the vast number of worlds where life could potentially exist under the right conditions, NASA and other space agencies take the risk of contamination between our world and other planets very seriously. The discovery of life among the stars would be a groundbreaking achievement, but the last thing we want is to realize that we unintentionally introduced it there through contamination. The contamination of other planets, moons, or asteroids can occur through what scientists refer to as forward contamination. This involves the transportation of terrestrial microscopic organisms from Earth to other celestial bodies, often by hitching a ride on equipment that was not adequately cleaned. When it comes to missions to Mars or Jupiter's moon Europa, where conditions for life are theoretically possible, contamination protocols become even stricter. On the other hand, backward contamination entails unknowingly bringing back extraterrestrial microbes from space. These life forms could spread throughout the universe by hitching rides on meteoroids, comets, or even space dust. Panspermia, a theory that suggests life may have traveled through space and arrived on Earth, could potentially explain the origins of life on our planet. While the dangers of deadly exposure in the vast expanse of space exist, we also face a different kind of exposure closer to home, online. Personal information and private lives being readily accessible online can be unnerving and leave individuals vulnerable. Similarly, space missions carry the risk of contamination, and it is increasingly challenging to prevent it entirely. For instance, when Elon Musk sent his Tesla into space, the necessary protection measures against interplanetary contamination were likely not taken into account. With the rise of commercial space launches, contamination may become the norm, making it nearly impossible to avoid. An example that illustrates the challenge of preventing contamination is the crash of an Israeli lunar lander on the moon in 2019. The lander carried thousands of microscopic organisms called tardigrades, known for their ability to withstand extreme conditions such as freezing temperatures and high radiation. These organisms, if present on the moon, could adapt and grow in microgravity or conditions similar to those found on Mars permafrost. To mitigate the risks, precautionary measures to prevent forward contamination are crucial. To minimize the risks associated with forward contamination, rigorous chemical cleaning and heat sterilization of spaceships should be implemented to eliminate any life on the exterior surfaces. Additionally, strict policies should be established for human missions to Mars, specifying landing and exploration zones well in advance. By carefully planning and taking precautionary measures, we can control and contain contamination within designated exploration zones before venturing into other parts of the Red Planet. While forward contamination is concerning, the accidental introduction of extraterrestrial life to Earth is equally alarming. The discovery of life, fossilized or alive, on Mars is not entirely implausible, particularly in water-rich areas of the planet. However, if Martian organisms share a biological origin with life on Earth, they could find our planet a suitable habitat. Invasive space microbes could potentially outcompete and endanger various organisms, including humans, as they act as pathogens. These extraterrestrial parasites, fungi, or viruses could be resistant to our immune system, silently replicating and spreading within our bodies until they manifest themselves. The consequences could include the emergence of alien organisms, rapid growth, release of deadly spores, and uncontrolled infections, ultimately leading to the extinction of species. To mitigate the risks associated with backward contamination, it is crucial to establish and adhere to strict rules and protocols for returning spacecraft, crew, and any potential biological samples they carry. Historical examples, such as the Apollo missions, demonstrate the effectiveness of quarantining astronauts after their return and subjecting lunar samples to thorough life detection and biohazard protocols. In the case of transporting samples from Mars, assuming they are dangerous until proven otherwise is essential. Proper containment should be maintained throughout the spacecraft's journey, including re-entry into Earth's atmosphere and delivery to quarantine facilities. Distribution of samples should only occur after scientists have verified the absence of biological life. In instances where doubts persist regarding containment, the spacecraft and samples must be sterilized in space to prevent any potential threats from reaching Earth. As we venture further into space and explore the possibility of life beyond Earth, the threat of space microbes and the risks of contamination become increasingly significant. Implementing strict contamination protocols, focusing on both forward and backward contamination, is crucial for protecting our planet and other celestial bodies. By understanding these risks and taking proactive measures, we can continue to explore the wonders of the universe while safeguarding our own existence.